Maybe it's just me, but this new DaVinci Resolve 18.5 beta is one of the most exciting ones that they've put out in a while. And while there are a bunch of new exciting upgrades in it, the one that really stands out to me is the new automatic subtitle feature. And I'm not just saying that because I've paid thousands of dollars for professional subtitles for my videos over the past couple of years and now it's completely free. I'm also saying it because for short form vertical content, having captions on screen is super important. And now it's super easy. So without further ado, secure the cup and I'll show you how to do subtitles for your projects. Okay, so we're here in DaVinci Resolve. I've got a project that I'm already done and all we're gonna do is add subtitles to it. Now, right now I'm in the beta version, the public beta of DaVinci Resolve Studio 18.5. So if you're watching this right when I put out the video, you do have access to the public beta. I'll leave a link down in the description if you wanna go check that out. But fair warning, it is a beta, so there are some bugs and that kind of stuff going on. Don't use this on anything that it is super imperative that it doesn't ruin. But going back to the project, this is a review for the Sony ZV-E1, and what I wanna do is add subtitles to the entire thing so that I can then upload those to YouTube, and the best part is just how easy this is. We've got three different tracks of dialogue, so A1, A2, and A3 are two dialogue tracks and a little voiceover track going on there, so there's lots of different dialogue. All we're gonna do is go up to timeline, and we're gonna go create subtitles from audio. And as long as we're selected on this timeline, when we click that, it should work great. A little dialogue box pops up that allows us to choose the language. In my specific case, it only allows me to choose English for now. We've got a couple of different options for caption presets. We're just gonna leave this on subtitle default. And then the max characters per line, if you wanna limit how many characters can be on each line as it's creating the subtitles, I'm just gonna leave this at 42 for now and click create. Now we just have to wait a little bit. We're looking at probably less than a minute for this 12-minute long video. So I'll just speed up this part so you don't have to watch through it. So now it's done analyzing, and as you can see, it popped up with this new track called Subtitle 1. There are 433 different clips on it. And if we zoom in here, you can see each of these is a little subtitle. Now on the screen, we can see as well. So if we pick a part here and watch through
for a beginner.
So how do you know if the ZV-E1 is the right camera for you? Well, first, so on that short section, it looks like it's done a pretty darn good job. It found where that sentence was. It put a question mark at the end of it. It's got commas in the next sentence. It's kind of crazy how good of a job it does. So the next step in this would be to go through and check to make sure that it didn't screw up anywhere. Sometimes it can mishear things. So I would just go back to the start of my video and then I would just watch it through all the way and make sure that everything was right. And an extra tip for you, if you hit L a couple of times, it'll start speeding up the playback. So if you want to try and get through it a little bit quicker, then you can totally do that.
Does it seem to have a love-hate relationship with the idea of the Sony ZV-E1? And the question is, what?
So there's like a funny little thing here where for some reason it added a little gap, so we might want to fix that. One thing that kind of blows me away is the fact that when I said Sony A7R5, it knew to make it a lowercase a, 7, uppercase R, and then the Roman numeral for 5. That's very specific, so there's something really awesome going on in the background there. Now, I'm 9 minutes into this video and it has been flawless so far, but if you do find something that you want to fix up, for example, I've got this part where it says 16 to 35, and I would rather it have a 16-35 than the word 2 in there. All we need to do is make sure that we open up our inspector, and if we're clicked on something like a video clip, it's going to show us the inspector for that. But if we click on one of our captions, it's going to open up the caption inspector. So I can just go in, delete the word 2, add a little dash in there, and we are good to go. And you can click in here as well, so if you see anything on one of your captions here, they're all numbered, you can just click on it, it'll move the cursor to that point, and you can change whatever you need to change in there. So now I've gone through the entire video and made sure that all the captions were correct, and it was insane how spot on they were. And so now the question is, how do we actually use those? How do we get those subtitles where they need to be? So for a YouTube video, I don't actually want the subtitles to be on there, so what I need is to get a subtitle file that I can then give to YouTube so that people can turn them on and off as they want. So all we're gonna do here is I'm gonna go up to File, I'm gonna go to Export, and I'm gonna choose Subtitle. It's saving an SRT file, which is a standard subtitle file. And make sure that you choose Subtitle File without formatting. And then if we want, we can actually hide these by disabling our subtitle track. Once I've got my video uploaded to YouTube, all I have to do is go into my YouTube studio, choose Subtitles, Upload File with Timing, and hit continue. Then I go find that file and I hit open. The other thing that I like to use subtitles for is actually putting the captions on the screen for things like short form content where people watch without the sound on a lot of the time. So for example, I've got this one Instagram reel that I posted where I was just babbling the whole time and I want to create subtitles. So we're going to go through the same process. Timeline, create subtitles from audio. This time, because it's vertical, it automatically changed it to 18 characters per line, which is nice. So again, I go through and make sure that everything is correct, but this time I want to actually make sure that it looks good on the screen. So what we're going to do is go back to our captions inspector. So we're going to click on any of these. And right now they're kind of all linked together on the track. So if we click over here on track, we now have the ability to go in and change a bunch of things about the font and the background and the stroke. For example, up here at the top, let's say I want to change the font to Futura. I want to change the size, make it a little bit smaller. We can center it, maybe move it up a little bit. I'm going to change the color to black, get rid of the stroke by changing the size of the stroke down to 0. We could add a drop shadow if we want, but in this case, what I want to do is add a background and then change that background color to this nice yellow, crank the opacity up. So now when we watch this through, I'm starting to think that maybe I'm cursed. So now we've got good looking captions on the screen, but they're all exactly the same. What if I wanted to just change one to kind of emphasize it? Let's say we wanted to take I'm cursed here. I'm going to go back to the caption inspector, choose customize caption, and it's kept everything that I had on the track for now, but we can customize just bits and pieces of it. So if I customize the size and make it bigger, or if I want to change the font a little bit. So now we've got our regular font for the rest of the track, and that one is just customized for that moment.
I'm starting to think that maybe I'm cursed. Story time.
Recently, now there are definitely some limits here. You don't have the same kind of control that you have over things like fusion titles. You can't animate them in or out, unfortunately. Maybe that's something that they'll add in the future. But now that we've got them looking decent on screen, how do we export them with our video? So we're gonna go to our deliver page and I'm gonna choose my preset for 1080 vertical. And then down at the bottom here, there's a drop down called subtitle settings. If we want to export that subtitle, we need to make sure this is clicked. Now we can choose as a separate file, which will actually export the SRT file that we did before, but at the same time as we're exporting the actual video itself. Then we can do it as embedded captions. So some programs will be able to read embedded captions built into the video file. And then this third option here is what we actually want for this video. It's called burn into video, which basically means that it's going to make that part of the video file itself. So we're actually going to see that yellow background with the black text on top of it in that final video. And then all we do is hit add to render queue and render it, and we're good to go. So now you know how to automatically make subtitles for your videos and how you can do a bunch of different things with them in DaVinci Resolve version 18.5. If you enjoyed this video and you got something out of it, try watching this one next. I think you'll really like it. Make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to the channel as well. Huge thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.